My name is Witty Himaira. I'm the author of Bravura. This is my sixth book in the French language, and I am so honored to be a French author. Oh, Bravura is a story of two men. One man is called Michael, and he is the nephew of the uncle of the story, Sam. And so Michael is given a diary by his auntie Pat. He has never been aware of the existence of Sam, who fought in the Vietnam War. And when he opens up the diary, all of Sam's life and love falls out. When Michael opens the diary, he discovers a great secret, a secret that the family has hidden for many, many, many years. And so then the book goes backwards into Sam's story, the reason why the secret has been kept by the family. And it is a Maori family, a very strong military family with a military tradition. So in Sam's story, the uncle's story, Sam goes to Vietnam because his father is a military man, so he's only going to Vietnam because his father wants him to carry on the military tradition. And then while he's there, he realizes that that is not what he wants his life to be, that he doesn't want a particular heterosexuality in that life. And he meets an American helicopter pilot. And so he and the helicopter pilot are very unaware of the attraction that they have for each other. But war is a time when things go crazy. You do things that you would not normally do in peacetime. And what these two men find in each other, Sam and the American helicopter pilot, Cliff, is the opportunity to find peace in each other during this time of war. They find a deep friendship, a very strong, deep friendship that helps to sustain them over the whole period of the war until Sam returns to New Zealand, to his father. Well, when Cliff arrives back in New Zealand, both boys discover that the conflicts of peace are almost as terrible as the conflicts of war, in the sense that they then have to sort out how they're going to navigate themselves further during peacetime. So all of my books are about the need for the world to change, and patriarchy is one of those processes that definitely need to change. So I wrote an earlier book called The Whale Rider, La Baleine Tatouée. And in La Baleine Tatouée, the patriarchal opposition is a young girl called Pai. So that particular book was an attempt to say women need to be affirmed and patriarchy is stopping them from empowering themselves. So in Bravura, what is happening there is the patriarchy of the Māori family, and in fact the patriarchy of the world, is preventing this relationship between men to occur too. So all my life I have been fighting patriarchy in all of its guises and in all of its forms, and because we have to emancipate ourselves and realize that equity, equality and justice are the expectation of any individual, regardless of their gender, regardless of their race, regardless of their nation, and regardless of their humanity. I love writing. I love trying to make the world work in a better way, and especially in New Zealand. I'm always energized to find new solutions so that we can continue to be better people and to be certainly more humanitarian and to treat each other much better than we have in the past. In my personal life, I became the chairperson of a gay organization that was looking after gay men and women during a time when they had no support, they had no governmental support, they had no way of becoming themselves except except by being punished. They were always punished by society. So what happens in the book is a reflection of you know, of my own life and aspirations as a gay man. And it's been a profound opportunity for me to interpret my life and put it into the book. So you could say that I am Michael. I did have an uncle called Sam who went to war. The Korean War was too far behind in our history, and so for the book I researched and changed the location to Vietnam. I think Vietnam is an interesting country and an interesting place in terms of French history too, French history in Indochina. So I'm hoping that the book will do well here. One of the things that that Sam discovers when he is in the war is that the Vietnam people look like him. And so he wonders why he's fighting that war with white soldiers against the Vietnamese people. So the various layers of the book are very, very complex. I hope that the readers will enjoy the complexity of Bravour.